Assignments, it will help you with the test.
Amen.
assignment is to clean and to serve. Yo, whatever your assignment is, it will help you with the test that life gives you.
Amen.
We all have assignments. Yes. If David had been on his assignment, we all have assignments and things we need to do. Things we need to do. And just knowing your assignment isn't the task. People, not even people that we know. You know, not even people that we know. But people that James knew, and who he wrote this letter for, seems to, like, they know it all and yet do nothing.
Amen.
Some people that know it all and do nothing. You can't tell them anything, but they have an opinion on what you should be doing.
Amen.
Maybe you don't know any people like this, but James does. James knows some people like this. It's like their assignment has become to tell everyone else what assignment they should be doing. Instead of doing something for themselves. James knew some people like this. People who knew better but didn't do better.
Amen.
Knowing the highest levels of theologies, but living like heathen. Philosophically prestigious, but practically pitiful. Useless. Having a form of godliness, yet denying the power. In chapter 1, James tells us about that religion without works is dead. In chapter 2, James tells us that faith without works is dead. And here in chapter 3, James tells us that wisdom without works. Who among you is wise and understanding? And Paul said in Corinthians, where is the wise man in this age? Where is the scribe? Where's the smart man? Don't you know God has shamed the wise and used the foolish things of the world to do? And who's wise among you? See, James is talking to the whole church, but he has his eye on the leadership first. He says to the teacher, to the preacher, to the speakers, he says, who of you is wise? And if you're so wise, let him show it. Not let him tell it. People always have a lot to say.
Yes. Amen. Yes. Amen.
But when it's time to get busy, they get lost. Let him show it. So it's not about how much you know, but what you do with what you know. At a point, it has to move away from getting all this information to application. What are you going to do with what I've given you? We all pray for a new word from God, a new manna to fall from heaven, a rhema word, a logos word. God, just give me something fresh, a new anointing, a new blessing. And God is saying, what have you done with the things I've already given you?
Amen.
Yes, yes.
Stop trying to get more and do something productive with what you have. He says, to show me your wisdom by your good behavior.
Amen.
Show me your wisdom by your gentleness. You're so smart. You know so much. Show me by good behavior. That always says, I see better than I hear.
Amen.
said it, and I hear him.
What state you from, Dad? What are you from?
Missouri.
Yeah. He said, I'm from Missouri. Show me. Don't tell me. And he says, James says to the church, he says, show me by your good behavior the deeds of gentleness. For that's what is wisdom. You can be right in what you say and wrong in how you say it.
Amen. Yes. Amen. Yes. Amen. Yes. Amen.
Yes.
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 You can be right in what you say and be the wrong person to say it.
Amen.
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 Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Sometimes because of our own actions, we lose our witness.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
We taint our witness. We stain our witness. Who are you to tell me? Didn't I see you? If you are really to have wisdom and understanding, he says, then you have to have a gentle spirit. You have to have good behavior. That means that when you correct someone, you have to correct them in love and not harshly. Correcting someone in love and not harshly. You know, sometimes it's some people you just want to just snatch.
Amen. Amen.
But you have to correct in love. And sometimes snatching is love.
Amen.
Some of us, the Bible says that God has to snatch out of his fire. But if you say you know it all, yet you don't have good behavior, or you're not moving in gentleness, but instead you're doing things with bitter jealousy. Bitter jealousy is like you want to tell the truth because you're upset with someone. Your feelings is hurt, so you want to get even. It's like, now you want to do the right thing. Now you want to do it because you hurt. Now I'm in trouble now, and I'm going to get you in trouble. So the bitter jealousy is you doing the right thing for the wrong reasons.
Yes, yes.
Oh, I'm going to expose you. Who is the accuser of the brethren? Who is the accuser? I know I got a scholar or two in here this morning. Who is the accuser of the brethren?
Satan.
So if now you want to tell the truth out of a bit of jealousy and anger, I'm going to let them have it. Give them a piece of my mind. Or he says, if you're doing this with selfish ambitions of strife in your heart. See, the call of the believer is not just to do right, but to do right for the right reason.
Amen. Amen.
To do right for the right reasons. See, I've done right way before I accepted God truly in my heart. Oh, I did some right things. Not everything is right. Everything still ain't right. But I did some right things before I knew God. There's some things that I did right. But a lot of times I did those right things for the wrong reason.
Yes, yes.
You see,
yes.
Pride is a funny thing.
Yes, yes, yes.
Pride is a funny thing. Pride can keep you out of trouble. And it can get you into trouble. There were some things I wouldn't do because it was beneath me. I'm too proud for that. I won't go there with the heathens. So sometimes you may be doing good. And there's a lot of people, you know, like this, who are nice when it's convenient for them to be nice.
Amen.
When they want something. When they need something. I heard a story. I don't know if he told me this story or not that, but it's a story of, did you tell me about the guy with the $7? Was that you? So I heard a story of a homeless person on the side of the road.
Yeah.
And a couple of people were going by and was like, oh, this homeless guy, let's try to help him out. So they're scrounging in their pockets, They get all the change and a few dollars that they can get, so they come over with like $7. Some ashtray money and some money they had in the pocket, we're gonna give this homeless guy $7. He took the change and the dollars, and he threw the change back at him. 2 seconds ago, he was begging. But now what you give him is not good enough. Sometimes people do right. I'm asking, I'm polite, I'm nice, I'm saying yes, ma'am, yes, sir, but then when you don't give them what they want.
Yes, yes.
Do not be arrogant and so lie against the truth. This is a problem that a lot of the Jewish converts had. We see this rear its head in the book of Acts, and we see this in a lot of cultures, it permeates to a lot of people today. Their philosophy was, it is okay to lie to protect the truth. So if lying protects the truth, then it was okay. And that was a lot different from this Christianity that Jesus had introduced in, or this old religion that Jesus had brought back. It was a lot different. It was you don't lie to protect the truth. The truth will defend itself.
Amen.
Amen.
The truth will defend itself. God can defend himself. Truth, you just say the truth. So when you're doing the right thing for the wrong reasons, or you're doing the wrong thing, thinking that there's a right reason.
Yes, yes, yes.
Faith.
Come on.
Yes.
Faith. Don't be so arrogant to you would lie against the truth. For wisdom, that wisdom that is arrogant, that wisdom that is jealous, and that wisdom that does not come down from above. And it may be a wisdom, I guess, a knowledge or something, but it's not from above. Instead, James says that that's earthly. And we're called to something greater. He says that's natural. That's unspiritual. That's the natural man, nature, this. And he says that wisdom is demonic.
Amen.
Paul, he says that this knowledge, this worldly knowledge, you know, we all have a sense of knowledge in some area. You may have an accountant here, you may have a mechanic, you may have someone who knows a little about construction, you may have someone who knows a little bit about different kind of things. And we all know a little bit about some things. He says, Paul says, when we get to the point where we feel like we know it all, this knowledge causes people to be puffed up.
Amen.
One thing that I've learned is it's okay to say, I don't know. And it's okay not to know.
Amen.
It's okay not to know. It's okay to not know. Paul says this, sometimes you get so much knowledge, you get puffed up. You feel lofty and proud, and knowledge is nothing compared to love.
Amen.
Amen.
It says, knowledge may puff you up, but it doesn't build up the body. The body of Christ. If you don't love anyone with the knowledge you have, then you have not edified anything. Not even yourself.
Amen.
You can believe all you want that there is one true God. This is what scriptures say. That's wonderful. But even the demons know this. You see, this church was probably filled with a bunch of heretics. Heretics are people that take a truth in the Bible and make that the gospel. So they may take something that is true, but center their whole faith around that. They make things bigger than they are. They may make speaking in tongues the biggest thing about the faith. If you don't speak in tongues, then you're not saved. They may make baptism the biggest thing about the faith. Well, if you're not baptized in this way, or you say these names like this, then you're not saved. They may make something that is true about the faith the biggest thing about the faith and become heretic because they don't see the whole picture. They focus so much on one thing. And these people, whose James is speaking to, seem like they're struggling with some heretistic ways. They feel like they're right, and because they're right, you're wrong. It's not about what you know. Because the demons know who God is.
Amen.
The demons know who God is. Not only do they know who he is, they fear and tremble before him.
Yes.
Yet, they are unchanged. Ooh. You know some people that know God? There are people that know God. They will come in here with snot bubbles and tears in their eyes and fall on their face before God and won't change.
Amen.
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 Yes. Won't change.
Yes.
You see the solution as clear as day. And yet you still won't change. Keep bumping your head against it. Same old wall. Keep falling into the same old pits. There was a meme that I saw online. The guy who got a tattoo of his girlfriend's name on his body. They broke up. He got a tattoo over her name. Like a paintbrush going over her name. Then they got back together and he got a tattoo of her name underneath that. And then they broke up and he got a tattoo over her name again. He had 7 different tattoos brushing over her name. He had not figured it out. He has not changed. Demons know and tremble and fear God, yet they don't change. You're going to be different or what? For where there is jealousy and selfish ambition, strife, in that place, you will find disorder in every kind of evil. Every evil thing. People think because you know better, you do better. No, not necessarily. Sometimes when you know better, you're just more crooked and more sophisticated than being crooked.
Amen.
Gentle. He said, if you have show me your good behavior and your gentleness. If you're really wise, you show me in your gentleness. Being gentle is just showing care and respect for others in the way that you act and the ways that you speak.
Amen.
I'm showing you that I care because, see, you disrespected me, but I'm not going to respond on your level. Michelle LeBron said, when they go low, you go high. So just because you want to take it there, don't mean I have to go there with you. Us throwing mud at each other, dirt at each other. Only thing will happen is we'll both get dirty and we'll lose a lot of ground. So I'm not going to go there with you. I'm going to be gentle and showing you that I can have respect even when you don't.
Yes.
Amen. Because I recognize this flesh and blood. It ain't you that I have a problem with.
That's right.
I wrestle not against flesh and blood. So you are not my problem.
That's right.
So I can have respect for you and how I act or how I speak or how I don't speak. Because sometimes that's the best way to show respect. And you know what? I'm going to not put myself in position. I'm just going to avoid the toxic situation. He says, be gentle. He says, be reasonable. Being reasonable is the idea of being willing to yield. Being willing to yield. Being willing to stop and let them go. To let them have the floor. Every hill ain't worth dying on. There's a lot of issues going on today and conflict and back and forth and talk in the church, outside the church, discussions, arguments, different things about the jab. Do you get jabbed? Do you not get jabbed? Do I do this? Do I not do this? Is this a big issue? Should I get the shot? Should I not get the shot? Being reasonable is being willing to yield. So it's not about arguing with someone else about what they should do, because you're probably okay if you don't, you're probably okay if you do. It's being able to say, you know what? I respect your decision. I'm willing to yield. I'm not going to argue with you. I'm not going to fight with you. I say my piece. I'm not saying it to argue or force you to do anything. And then I step away. Being willing to yield. That's wisdom. Not losing a brother over this. Not losing a sister over this. Whatever it is, whether it's religion or politics. Being full of mercy. So mercy is when you don't give somebody what they deserve.
Amen. Amen.
It is. Yes.
Amen.
Grace is giving people what they don't deserve. Grace is not giving them, mercy is not giving them what they do deserve. So wisdom is the ability to show mercy. We got to work on mercy, y'all.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Some people earn this butt whooping. You know what? Mercy.
Yes.
Mercy.
Yes. Have mercy.
Mercy. And it says, wisdom is impartial. The wise man does not treat the rich man one way and the poor man a different way. He does not treat the black man one way and the white man another way. The wise man is impartial.
Amen.
Judging people, as King said, by the content of their character.
Yes.
And the wise man is free of hypocrisy. Does not say that the wise man is free of sin. The wise man is free of hypocrisy.
Amen.
A hypocrite is a stage actor, someone who wears a mask, who pretends to be one thing though they are not. The wise man is who he is.
Amen.
Take it or leave it alone. The wise man is this. If we're gonna work on being wise, we have to work on being authentic.
Yeah.
We have to work on being ourselves. We're gonna have to work on being vulnerable. We're gonna have to work on being free. Since the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace by those who make peace. The fruit of righteousness is sown in peace by those who make peace. The wise man makes peace. Makes him righteous. I want us to grow from. I want to know God. I want to show God.
Amen.
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 I want my light to shine so bright before men that they see my good works and glorify the Father who is in heaven. Because my wisdom without works dead.